With the impending move to alert level one, New Zealanders will be looking forward to returning to normality.
None more so than the contract cleaners at Auckland Council, many of whom had to endure the last 2 months living below minimum wage. Anauli Karimafai'ai has this story.
While New Zealanders celebrate their collective efforts over the last 2 months of COVID-19, it's left many trying to pick up the pieces.
We are worried about meeting our payments, you know, mostly our rent and our bills. And yeah, it's quite hard, you know, during lockdown.
People throughout the country have been hit hard by the pandemic lockdown, not least Pacific communities where many have succumbed to job losses and pay cuts.
When we put in place the wage subsidy scheme just over a week ago, we said
the government's wage subsidy scheme provided relief for those affected, but for some, it still wasn't enough.
I was trying to meet the needs, you know, of my our family, looking after my two kids. I was struggling, you know, surviving on food parcels.
Among the affected are the contracted cleaners for Auckland Council, who had their services suspended when the lockdown commenced. Many were living on just 80% of their income, unlike their employee counterparts who were paid full wages.
We did a calculation that was below the minimum wage. It was about $15.20 or something that we realised. So no wonder they were struggling in paying their bills and everything, yeah.
They're going to ask me to use my annual leave or like this from our employers. But in my situation, I have not enough annual leave at the moment. How can I use my annual leave? It's not enough for my 20%.
How can you have a wage that you can't live on?
This comes after Phil Goff's mayoral promises last year, where he vowed to pay council contracted cleaners the living wage if he won a second term.
There was a letter that Auckland Mayor Phil Goff wrote to our National Secretary. He made it quite clear that it's not his responsibility to pay those workers the 20%, that it's up to the contracted cleaners to top up the 20%.
We just don't know who to turn. Who's the right person at this point? Because apparently everybody's not even in council, they're not even helping us with our living wage, so we just don't know.
Now many of the cleaners are back to work, they're chasing a 20% back payment. But with the council staring down the barrel of a $500 million shortfall, staff pay cuts and redundancies, it isn't budging.
Referring back to the America's Cup, they come up with many millions and millions of dollars. They can afford to do that. And how come they don't have the money to pay their lowest paid workers? They may be contracted workers, but at the end of the day, they're still working for Auckland Council.
It's more stress and unfair to me because I get used to paying my bill on time and especially basic need for my family. How can I provide my family with the subsidy is not enough for me and my family.
Penny has since resigned from her employer and Auckland Council and started a new job earlier this week, but she isn't giving up on her 20%.
I think I'm still looking forward for that, you know, because I think I'm, you know, I deserve it. I know been working for them, you know, really hard. And it's something that I supposed to receive it. I wish, you know, the council will allow it, you know, and give me them know the money that they owe me.
In the meantime, the issue has garnered traction on social media, and a petition has been launched in support of the workers.
Don't play with our intelligence, because that's exactly what they're trying to tell us, that we are dumb, we don't know what we're talking about, you know? And to say that, oh, we have no mechanism in place to know how to top up these cleaners at 20%. Bloody hell, get a life and get real, you know?
We voted for them to be on those seats. So my message, please consider what you've been saying and fulfil it, please.
And we made contact with Auckland Council, who responded that there were limited legal grounds for them to tell external agencies how to pay their contracted cleaners, but said those employed by council continued to receive full wages.